Breaking news, Redot gets hacked a few moments after allegedly stealing code from Blazium. Stay tuned to hear the full story. Hey everyone, today we need to have a serious conversation about Redot. About 3 weeks ago, Redot broke away from Godot. The split happened because they felt Godot was getting too political, particularly with how they were banning users who disagreed with a certain tweet of theirs. Now, I've been looking at Redot 4.3 Beta 1, and I want to be completely honest with you. It's essentially Godot 4.3 with a different skin and icon. Even their documentations is just Godot's documentation with Godot replaced with Redot. Look, I'm not saying this to criticize. I honestly didn't expect Redot to be vastly different from Godot in just a month. But there's something that concerns me, and is their version naming that mirrors Godot's version. Before you click away or leave an angry comment, I am not a Redot hater. Please watch the full video to understand what I am really saying about Redot. Let's talk about my criticism of their version naming. I get it, it's based on Godot 4.3 and they want to make the transition easy for Godot users by avoiding confusion about compatibility. But here's the thing, naming Redot versions after Godot versions make it look like they're just playing catch-up. Unless Redot is meant to be nothing more than Godot with a custom skin and icon, I honestly think they should kick things off by naming it version 1, marking it as its own unique project. If they keep following Godot's version numbers, it could create confusion down the line, especially if Redot evolves beyond just being a visual reskin. Imagine this scenario. Redot 4.7 comes out, but it's not just a Godot 4.7 reskin anymore. It's something unique. Calling it 4.7 might make people think it's still tied to Godot's update. And if Godot's at version 4.8 by then, Redot might look outdated in comparison. Now, some might say being locked to Godot's footstep is actually good because it makes jumping ship seamless. To them, I have a question. Why isn't Redot just a Godot plugin then? If you're launching your own engine, it should be able to take its own path. So, here are my suggestions and advice for Redot. First, start with Redot version 1. This signifies that Redot is in its foundational stage. On your website and in your community, you can clearly state that right now it's a one-to-one with Godot 4.3 and that Godot users using Godot 4.x can seamlessly switch to Redot 1.x. This establishes that while it starts from Godot, it has its own journey ahead. Second, incremental versions should be made by major changes, not Godot releases. When Redot gains significant features beyond just a reskin or minor tweaks, bump up the major version. This way, Redot 2.0 or 3.0 will signify real progress and independence from Godot, even if it starts with some core similarities. Third, make a clear game plan for your engine. Mark Gam and the Apolitical engine don't say much about your plans. Actually, centering your branding as the Apolitical engine is ironically branding with politics, at least in my opinion. You should pick new branding while making it known that Redot doesn't pick political sides. I hear you want to implement some pull request features that Godot never really looked at, but still, what is Redot? Is Redot just Godot but red? Release a detailed plan and direction. Think about what aspects of the Godot engine you want to improve and let us know why we should choose Redot beyond just politics. Now, before we get to the question of whether Redot really stole from Blazium, I want to talk about the recent poll I made. I asked you, the viewer, what content you'd like to see regularly on this channel. We got 28 votes, I'm off recording this. And about half of you said you'd like to watch me attempt mechanics from popular games. The other half couldn't decide between watching full game tutorials or more of my Game Dev Essentials series. And hey, a little shout out to Sanji who suggested to make a 3D turn-based RPG. So, you guys have spoken. What mechanic from a popular game would you like to see me made in Godot? Let me know in the comments. Oh, and I will be killing off the intro to coding series. Instead, if you need help with your coding, understanding concepts, or want to show off what you are making, either for advice, help, or motivation, feel free to join our server and let's make games together or just hang out. The server is free and open to all. You'll find a link to our Discord server in the video description. Okay, so back to the question. Did Redot really steal from Blazium? For those who don't know, Blazium is yet another fork of Godot, started by Blaze and Starkium. You might remember Starkium or Life Art Studios. He was a Godot titanium donor who got blocked on X by Godot during the whole Godot situation. Blaze and Starkium were part of the Redot team but left because they said they felt betrayed by the team. Their exact reason for the separation are unclear, but when asked about the issue, Starkium replied, "It's a complicated string of events that are both hurtful and leads to distrust. Can't work in that environment. But there are devs still over at Redot who have what we left there, so we wish them the best of luck." Starkium also tweeted that another reason he was leaving was that his friend Blaze was treated poorly even though he did 90% of the work. But from the looks of it, Blaze wasn't really popular in the Redot community. Some members, particularly Sola, made fun of the Blazium name, calling Blaze and Starkium their favorite e-couple. Atomic said, "All updates to Blazium will be assimilated to Redot. We are Legion." This was probably foreshadowing what would come next. If you were expecting big drama, well, Monir claimed that Redot stole the code they committed to the Blazium engine without attribution or copyright notice. Now, everything was under the MIT license, and if you know your MIT license, it's a simple and permissive open source license that allows you to do almost anything you want with a program or code, as long as you include the original copyright notice and license text in your distribution. But when Redot borrowed Monir's code, Blazium hadn't updated their license, so it was technically under the Godot license. But now Blazium has updated the license and future code committed to the engine would be made under their license. This little event gave Redot and Blazium some more bad blood. And now, on to the breaking news. On October 26th at 8 AM Central Time or 2 PM GMT+1, Nikolai, a founder of Redot, announced on Discord that they had received an alert stating their X handle had been hacked. Now, cybercriminals need your personal information to target you with more and better tailored attacks, and that's where our sponsor... Just kidding, this video isn't sponsored. Anyway, the official Redot X handle was hacked. At first, the hackers named the account to Help X, then unfollowed everyone Redot was following. As of recording, the hacked account is now named V. Maybe a V for Vendetta reference? Every post made by Redot has been wiped out. Before I end the video, there's one thing I would like to point out. Maybe I'm overthinking it, but there seems to be a bit of hypocrisy with Redot and his philosophy. According to their website, Nikolai states, "I want to make Redot not just a great apolitical no-nonsense engine of the future, I want to see Redot become the standard for community engagement, community management, and open source projects." But before the Redot X account hack, the official Redot account was following Elon Musk. Now, I'm sure everyone knows that Elon doesn't shut up about his political views and where he stands politically, and I'm yet to rationalize the reason why the official account of an apolitical game engine would be following such an individual. Is Redot going to become the very thing they say they are fighting? I hope not. To be clear, if this feels like hate towards Redot, I assure you that I just hate things as I see them and I try to get rid of every bias. Maybe I'm mistaken, let me know in the comments below. And as always, don't forget to like if you liked, dislike if you disagree with my take, subscribe, and you can check out other ways to support my channel in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.